That is beautiful. Wow. This like kind of sucks, but like I have literally no power right now. It's storming like cats and dogs, and there's like really bad wind. I was headed out to class because like homegirl has anxiety for missing class. So like I was gonna travel through horrible weather to get there since I live off campus. And then literally I was telling Carissa because she's not here because she is over at someone else's house at the moment and now she's like stuck there. And she was like, Amanda, like I am begging you, please do not go to class. So I didn't because like she's not really the type of person to like get like that when she knows that like I don't want to go to class, but I also am like like don't want to miss. So I didn't, and then immediately as like I was headed towards the door though, like I'm texting her about it, the lights went off. So we have not had power for about an hour and a half now. And I am alone. And like I don't mind storms, but something about like just like the really, because I can hear the wind like up against my window because I'm in my bathroom at the moment because they were like, take shelter. And I was like, okay, so I'm in my bathroom. And it's also like a lot quieter in here, and I don't have to listen to the wind as loudly. So that's where I'm chilling with my handy dandy flashlight. But yeah, and I was like, wow. I talked to my aunt for like an hour and some change because I didn't want to be alone. Because and then I also was like crying because I was like, I'm alone, and like my brain immediately went to like, I'm gonna die alone, and like that's like one of my biggest fears is dying alone. So like that was soups fun. And then I was sitting here like, I could do a YouTube video, and I was like, I'll do a YouTube video. So, and also my battery was dying, so I was like, I'm gonna go because don't want to kill my battery since I don't know when it will get power back since the conditions have to improve before they can get out there. I'm also literally still in like my rain jacket and my rain boots, so like thriving. I'm prepared though. I'm prepared if suddenly like a window breaks, God forbid, the door breaks, God forbid, and like a lot of water comes through because we also have like a back balcony deck. I'm like, I don't want that to break. I could go show you guys what it's like outside. Yeah, that is outside at the moment. So, yeah, that's what it looks like outside. Do I look spooky like this? Today, we're going to be sitting around the campfire and telling spooky stories. It is currently like 6:30. I'm really, really hungry. I have had one of these to eat because I was like, I need something to eat, but like, really, really want dinner. But in the meantime, I was like, I will do a YouTube video, and I have a funny idea in my head. I doubt it's gonna come out as great through camera because like haven't done really anything for it. Just throw it together in my mind. So we'll see. But anyway, I am going to, I guess, be doing ways that you can occupy yourself when the power's out and you have nothing to do. Or I could just make this a vlog. I'll probably do one if it sucks. Like, Becca, can you like cut it out? Because like, don't want to keep that. But anywho, let's get into the video. Okay, so like the first thing that you can do when you don't have power is you can just sit on your phone until the battery starts dying. And that's what I did. But then my battery started dying. I was like, well, gotta turn that off. And I was talking to my friend, and she was like, why don't you just do a spooky ghost time story? And I was like, because I just got rid of one, and like, I don't know. I don't really have any other good ghost stories to tell. I also don't want to like invite it back by like talking about it. But she was telling me because she has. This is just gonna turn into a vlog, apparently. I took my jacket off, though, so like, my friend was like followed by like a ghost for a while, or a spirit, I don't know. And apparently it was a very horny spirit, and I find that like kind of amusing, because like I guess like that's not like my first thought when I think about it, like ghosts or spirits, is that like they're horny. But yeah, apparently it was, like, fun fact, they can be. But then like I was watching, like she told me that, and then I was watching one of Shane Dawson's series about it. Or not about like that, but where they were going ghost hunting on the Queen Mary, which if you haven't watched it, like you should. His ghost hunting series are some of my favorites. Ooh, Carissa texted me. Oh, good. She said that, okay, so she's at my Biggs place, and she was like, so she just showed us someone's Snapchat video, and it shows the road from, like, the restaurant right up here, and apparently it's completely flooded, so she can't even get back to the apartment. Good. And they were, like, going ghost hunting on the Queen Mary, and I guess that, like, he had gone there with, like, a friend, and, like, things were, like, I guess there was, like, a ghost there that, like, would try and, like, take the clothes off of, like, girls who were staying in the room or something. I don't know. That's something like that. So I guess, like, they can be. But she was haunted by that for quite some time. So, like, that's fun. Not really. And, like, apparently, like, she would feel, like, someone touching her leg and, like, it would freak her out. And other stuff. Yeah, so that's that ghost story. I don't know if it's... I've, like, briefly mentioned the little girl and the... room at my grandparents' house, like you've heard that. Oh, I know another ghost story. I love how this is literally just sit around and tell ghost stories around the campfire or something like that. Now that I've like changed the lighting like 500 times and watched it back to see which was better, back to my story of the other ghosts that I just blew into my face. Back to the other story of the, like, ghost, I guess. So at my, Papa's house, different grandparents. They're all Papa, though, so, like, it gets confusing. I'm sorry. But at his house where, like, my mom, like, I don't know if she grew up there, but, like, they moved there when she was, like, in her teens, I think. There, like, is a lake, and then at the house, like, right across the lake from their house is, there's a ghost there, apparently. And, like, my sister has experienced this one more than I have. And, like, there's stories all about it. And one of them is, like, so her grave is, like, on site. It's at the house. Like, I've seen it. I've been over there. Like, bitten. Like, I don't know if I've met the current owners, but I did meet, like, the past owners. I just don't remember, like, they still live there. They sold it. But, they were, I guess, building something. There was, like, construction workers there. And they, like, looked up, and there was, like, a woman in the window. And they were, like, they called, and they were, like, hey, like, is anyone home? Like, we didn't know if anyone was going to be here. Like, if so, like, that's fine, but, like, we just didn't know. I don't even know if that was. And they were, like, no one's there. Like, and so they looked up again, and, like, she was gone. And so, she has a name. I forget what her name is. But it's, like, it's the woman who died, and, like, her grave is there. I just don't remember what her name is. I want to say it's, like, Abigail or something. But, and then me, my sister, my step-cousin, and someone else was over there. I might have been one of my friends. I don't remember. But we were over there one time playing with someone, and, like, we were in the hallway, and Becca, like, turns around. Becca's my sister, in case, like, you didn't know that. She turns them around, and she looks at me, she's like, let go of me, and I was like, I'm not touching you. And she was like, I felt you, and I was like, literally, I haven't, like, touched you at all. And, because, like, she felt, I think it was, like, someone who grabbed her around the arm. And she edits the videos, so, like, if I'm wrong, Becca, you can put up where, like, you had felt touched, but I want to say it was, like, the arm, like, it felt like someone had, like, grabbed her, and I was like, boo-boo, I have not touched you. I think one of the, like, smoke detectors is going off. I think that's what's happening. Back to the regularly scheduled program, now that I have room on my memory card. And that the wind has shut up for a brief second. Oh yeah, so like I have gotten like, I felt like a really cold spot one time when I was there. And I was like, oh, don't like that, because, like, I knew that, because I used to, like, I, like, grew up watching, like, ghost stories of my, like, ghost hunting things with my dad, and so, like, I'd kind of, like, known, like, what to look out for, and I was like, ooh, girl, this place is haunted. I think my mom has had, like, some sort of experience or another while there. So, like, that, I think, is really all, like, the ghost stories I have, except one time we were watching Ghost Hunters, when I was younger with my dad, I had made, like, a get out type of sound. Like, it was a lot better than that one, but, like, it was one of my proudest moments. It sounded super scary, and I was like, who is she, though? It's just little me. And my dad, like, was convinced that it was on TV, and he kept rewinding, and he was like, you girls heard that, right? And we were like, yeah, Dad, of course we did. Like, we definitely heard it. And then finally he kept replaying, and I was like, Dad, it was just me. Like, it was a joke. I thought it was funny. He was not entirely amused, but, like, it's fine. But that's all my ghost stories. If you have any ghost stories, leave them down below. I'd love to hear them. I think they're really interesting to see how, like, a lot of people, you know, have had, like, an experience, and then some people would just write it off, and they're like, it's not anything. Like, they can write it off. Like, my sister's boyfriend, he can write off anything. Like, he doesn't believe in the supernatural, which, like, teach their own. And, like, sometimes I wish I was that way, because then I think I'd be a lot less spooked in life, because I'd be like, oh, it's just this or that, and, like, I'm not that way. Sometimes I really wish I could be. I'm also sorry that I look so rough right now, because, like, it has been a day, it's been a week, you know, the power's out, my hair looks a mess, because it was humid out earlier, so I just threw it in a bun, you know, that's the way life be. But this is one of my favorite sweatshirts. I got it when I was in Cape Cod. You can't tell, there's the Cape Cod, Massachusetts logo. I feel like that's one of those places. There are a few places that, like, I genuinely think that everyone, like, if you live in the U.S., like, you should go and see if you can, or at least if you live on the East Coast. And for me, one of those places is Cape Cod. It's so gorgeous. I didn't go during, like, prime season, and even then I thought it was, like, just absolutely stunning. I would love to go when, like, it's because they were getting ready for tourist season when I went, and I think that Cape Cod's definitely one of those places that everyone should see at least once in their life if they live in the U.S. or, like I said, on the East Coast. And then the second one that I, like, genuinely believe that, like, I think everyone should experience for, like, just once in their life is New York City. I, like, genuinely think that everyone deserves and, like, should just see it and experience it once, because if you know me, you know that I absolutely love New York City. Like, I want to live in New York one day. It's my dream. Like, I literally walked out of the train station the first time I ever went, and, like, I literally just, like, stopped and I took it in, and I was like, I feel like I'm home. You know that, like, just sense and, like, that feeling of when, like, you go home after, like, a really long time you've been away, and you're like, oh, I'm home, like, this is amazing. That's how it felt for me when I first went to New York, and it was, I think I like it so much because it's so busy, it's so fast-paced, which is, like, how I feel my life already is, but, like, everyone is that way, and everyone's fast. You don't have to talk to anyone, like, bruh, that's like, a dream. It's to not be stopped by, like, everyone on the street to be asked, like, how you're doing, and everyone has RBF, so, like, I'd fit right in. I also have RBF. I either have RBF or have, like, resting sad face. Like, I have people come to me, like, are you okay? I'm like, I'm fine. Like, why? Like, you just look really sad. I'm like, no, I'm fine. I'm probably tired, but I'm not sad. But that's another one. And then, like, I know there are a few other places that, like, people mention. Like, I feel like California is something, like, people agree that you should probably see once. My mom says that, like, she'd like to visit it, but she can never live there. And, like, I agree with that. I don't know if I could ever live in LA, like, or California. Maybe, like, Northern California. But they also have a lot of wildfires. And, like, I'm not about that. And they don't really have the seasons. And I love my seasons. So, I don't know. I don't know if it's something, like, I could live in, but, like, I get why people live there, especially, like, if they're looking for, like, opportunities one after another. Like, I feel like New York and LA, or, like, New York City and LA are, like, the two places that you get that, but, like, more of them come from LA, so, like, I get why a lot of people move out there. The Grand Canyon, I know, is one. I think my grandparents are going there, or they wanted to go there. I'm not sure. I know they talked about it. Like, they were going to road trip out there, and I was like, that's cool. I aspire to be my grandparents, TBH. Like, they're honestly just, they're such goals. And they've been together for help. But yeah, they've been together for, like, 50 years maybe? Has it been 50? I think so, like 40 or 50 years. Been together for a while. They've been together since high school. Back when people like could last that long, I guess. And even back then, I don't think people really lasted like for high school through such and such. But I mean, I guess they did. I feel like it's like post war when people started going off to college. We're like, I don't think there's anything wrong with not being the person you've been with since you were 18. Like, I think it's good to like grow. I don't know. That's a whole different story though. Well, they've been together for like ever, and they're super cute, and I have divorced parents, so like, I guess in a way, like, I didn't have like a relationship to like look up to almost, because like mine were divorced since like I can remember. They got divorced really early on, and so I didn't have that. And then like they were always, I guess, like the couple I looked up to and wanted to have a relationship like. And I mean, I still do, because they work so well together. And I've like asked, now that I'm older, like, how have you done it for like that long? Because like so many people these days don't make it that long. And they're like, and my grandma always tells me, she's always like, Amanda, it's just like communication, and like you don't give up when things get hard. And you know, that's mainly what she tells me. She's like, you need to communicate. And she's like, I'm not gonna like lie to you and say that things have always been great for us. She's like, we definitely fight, we have bad moments, but we also have a lot of good moments. And you have to focus on all of those good moments that you have, instead of focusing and staying focused on like all your bad moments or a bad moment that happened. Because she's like, when you love someone, like, you don't just give it up. And you know, so I don't know, it's always something that I've looked up to and I've wanted to have a relationship like. And so I think subconsciously, almost, I've like been waiting to find someone that I can have that sort of relationship like, where like you tease each other, but like you also just love each other so much. And I wish I could do like an entire video just on them, or like of them, because they're really cute. And my papa, his advice to me, his own, like, one of his only pieces of advice to me about boys and guys in general, I had to be like 11 or 12. No, I might have been older. I'm gonna put the time range between probably like 12 and 16. That's a big time range, I know, but like, that's about the age range that this had to be in. And he was giving my nanny a foot rub. He looks over at me and my sister, and he goes, I want you girls to know that you should not settle for a man unless he will give you a foot rub. And so if you need wise advice from my grandfather about men, there you go. Don't settle for a man who won't give you a foot rub or a massage. So I've always found that one piece of advice so amusing for some reason, just that he's like, you shouldn't settle for anything less. I'm like, thank you. Like, that's the one piece. I thought it was really cute though. Something about that comment to this day just gets me, because I find it really amusing, but it's also sweet, I guess, in a way, you know, to be like, you know, you shouldn't settle for someone who's not willing to do something like nice for you. I think it's the moral of it, like, don't settle for someone who's not gonna do something nice for you, and is always focused, I guess, on like themselves, you know, which I guess is knowledge, but some people don't know that. So there's my wise dating advice from my grandfather that has now been passed on to you. But yeah, I was gonna do, like I was saying, a makeup video of like get ready with me as I do my makeup in the dark as the power's out. But then I was like, I'm alone and like just got rid of something, and I, like I said, I'm kind of like low-key scared of the dark still. And it's not even like I'm scared of like the dark itself. I'm more so scared of the fact that, like, I'm scared of the unknown, and when it's dark, I can't see, so therefore it is an unknown thing, and I don't like it. What else should we talk about? My friend's got a kitten, this week, and she is the most precious kitten that I have, like, literally ever seen. She's so cute, she's so tiny, and she's a little orange cat, and growing up, like, we had cats, but we never had an orange one, and so, like, I've always wanted an orange kitten, and they have one, and she's so cute, and they keep sending me videos, and I'm in love with her. I want one so bad. I kept asking my mom if I could, like, get a cat,
And she said that, like, I could. And then I started rethinking my life. I didn't know where I was going to be in a few years. And, like, it's bad to, like, uproot a pet. And so I decided against it. But there are days that I really wish that, like, I had gotten one. Because I think it would help me cope better with school. Because, like, I don't really do well with just, like, a lot of the stress and, like, anxiety of it all. Because I'm so hard on myself. And I try to be, like, perfect in everything I do, and so, like, school, especially my major, can be really hard on me because I don't always feel like I'm the smartest in it. I kind of sometimes just feel like I'm really dumb and I don't understand what I'm doing, and I try to be, like, super, super perfect about it all, and it, like, just, it takes a really big mental toll on me because I'm my own harshest critic, and when you're not the best or when I'm not perfect at something, like, I get really down on myself. And so I overwork myself to make sure I'm doing my best and putting my best foot forward, which I think is sometimes why I'm not always, like, super pleased with, like, my own YouTube videos, because, like, I feel like I could do it better, and I watch it back, and I'm like, I wish I had, like, said these things or done this, and I know that part of it could probably be helped if I would practice, like, looks, but for me, that's not something that I do, and I don't want to be, like, I guess, disingenuous. Because if you know me, I'm not someone who, like, practices a lot of things. I, like, go out and do it for the first time, and just, like, either I do it right or I don't. And, like, I guess on one hand, like, the YouTube has taught me to be okay with not being perfect at everything I do, and it's okay to learn. And learning's really good for you because it's just the human experience. Like, we all need to learn. That's one thing, like, I do appreciate from being on YouTube is that I'm learning with each video, like, how to do something better and how to be a better YouTuber. And I remember, it's just, sometimes it's really hard for me because, like, I don't get things right away always, or I don't get it the right way the first time, which sometimes I struggle with. I am a bit of a perfectionist. Like, that started kicking in more in, like, high school and especially college, is my, like, perfectionist attitude. And that has crossed over into videos, which is why sometimes, like, my sister has even pointed out to me, I was putting out videos that, like, I wasn't, like, super involved, not, I don't want to say involved in, but, like, I just wasn't super into, and I was, like, just putting them out there to put them out there because, like, I post Tuesday, Thursday, and, she could tell, she was, like, these aren't your best videos, like, they're not, like, great, like, I don't want to lie to you, and I was like, no, like, you're right, like, they aren't, and she's like, I'm not trying to be mean, and I get that you're probably really stressed from school, but I'd rather you put your best foot out there than just garbage videos, and I was like, I mean, you right, and so that kind of caused, like, took me to reevaluate, and I've gone back and forth if, like, during the semester, especially this semester, if I should take a step back and only post once a week. I still haven't decided. I try to get them out there because, like, she needs to edit them, which, like, shout out to her because, like, I know for her, too, she's the same way of, like, having a perfectionist attitude and always wanting things to be perfect. So I know when she first started, like, editing again for the first time in a while, she would get annoyed because, like, it wasn't her best. Like, I get it. We should give her props, though, because, like, she has learned a lot, too, and, like, I can see it in her editing. Because if you watched my, like, story time of my apartment is haunted, like, the whole beginning I was really amazed by it, where she made it kind of like a horror movie trailer. I thought that was really cool. And, like, I feel very thankful to have someone who's willing to edit for me, because, like, if I had to edit, it would take me literally, like, a month. I suck at editing. Like, I've tried it. I'm not very good at it. And so I'm very thankful that she's willing to do it for me. But, like, I understand that, like, she needs them a few, like, a week or two in advance so that she can do it. Because, I mean, she has her own life. She has her own job. She does this for me to help me out, which, like, I greatly appreciate. And so I think almost in a way, like, YouTube has been good for both of us because I think it's kind of helped. I know it's helped me, and I'm hoping it's helped her, too, to, like, learn from it and learn from the experience and not always to learn that you don't always have to have it perfect on the first try, which I know we both have struggled with. We get it from our dad, though, so, like, we come by it honest. We definitely get the perfectionist attitude from our dad.
I'm hoping to continue to learn from it. Because I do genuinely enjoy making videos, and I enjoy being creative and making content. Because I remember I used to get so down on myself because I was like, I'm not creative, Mom. Like, I don't get it. Like, I'm just not creative. Like, I'm not good at art, and I'm not good at, like, musical instruments. Like, you know, and what grade is it? Like, fifth grade or something? Fourth grade? I don't know. But, is it fifth, like, fifth or sixth grade that you have to try out all the instruments to see if you can, like, do the school band? Trying to kill a bug. I remember sucking at every single instrument except for the trumpet, and I was like, why do I suck at this? And I, like, horrible at, like, painting and arts and crafts. Like, I'm so bad at it. It's bad. If you have watched any of, like, my DIY hacks, I think it's the second one, is when I have one where I try and do an arts and craft, and, like, oh my gosh, it comes out so bad. And so I would get really down on myself, and, like, she's like, well, you're not bad at art, because she's like, you're creative in a different way. And so, like, I could dance, and, like, that was my creative outlet a lot throughout high school and, like, in childhood and everything. Was I a dance, and, like, that was my creative outlet. And then, like, I went to school, and I'm technically part of the, like, STEM major because I'm a science major, and, like, it's all logical things and doing things analytically, and it's not always fun. And, like, I think that I kind of, like, had joy sucked out because I think everyone needs a creative outlet. And so, like, I'm glad I started YouTube, even though I don't have, like, the most followers or the most watch minutes or the most likes or comments or whatever. And, like, I've gotten down on myself about that, too, because, like, for me, again, it's that, like, I need this, and this to, like, be great at something, to know that I'm perfect at something. And I think all of it has just been a learning, like, curve for me to be, like, it's okay to, like, not have this and this and this. It's okay to learn as you're doing something, which I think I needed to know, you know? So, you know. But I think this has been a good, like, creative outlet for me to be able to do things, something that, like, I genuinely enjoy doing, and getting to be creative and come up with ideas and, like, live them out, even though, like, this video was not supposed to be a vlog, and it wasn't supposed to be me just going on and on about stuff. But thank you for listening if you've made it in this long. I don't know how long this is gonna be. I should probably cut it off so Becca doesn't get annoyed with me, because she hates when I do long vlogs. I've only done, like, one vlog, and it was, like, a week-long vlog, and she's like, there's too much footage, Amanda. And I was like, I'm sorry. Hopefully my power comes back soon. When it does, I will let you know. I'm hoping it comes on at some point tonight. It is currently 7:14, so we'll see. I need to eat something. I'm gonna go find something to eat too. But I'll do a sign off now, just because if I forget to, like, update you when my power comes back on and do an outro, then I'll at least have this one just in case I forget. And so, thanks again for listening to me ramble, even though it was just rambling all over the place. I love you guys, the ones that do watch, and have been watching for a while. Like, it means, I think, a lot more to me than I think you realize, because I know there are a few people who have been watching for a while, since I, like, started, and I appreciate that. Because it genuinely does mean a lot to me that, like, someone besides, like, my sister is watching me. So, yeah, thank you. And thank you for joining me in this vlog, and I will, if you enjoyed the vlog, if you want to see me do more vlogs, give this video a thumbs up. I'm not very good at vlogging. I feel so awkward. I've already asked you to comment. Tell me what your ghost stories are down below. And you can hit the red subscribe button if you're not already subscribed to me. You can hit the bell icon next to it to be notified every single time that I post. And I'll put up 2 videos somewhere. I don't know where. Because I feel like it's on my face. But it'll probably be on this side. It might be on this side. I don't know, I'm thrown out of whack because I'm not in my usual filming spot. But you can go and click those videos and go and watch some more videos of me. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.